Thousands and thousands of people have seen the video Mystery Fighter against Manny Pacquiao. This fighter did pretty good. We asked, who do you think it is? People said it's Victor Ortiz. People said Roy Jones Jr. People said all kinds of great fighters. But we have on the phone a Mystery Fighter. So Mystery Fighter, who are you?
It's your boy, the one you love to hate. Kareem Hard-Hitter Mayfield, live and direct, 140-pound NBO champion, baby.
Kareem Mayfield, you did very, very well against Pacquiao. How do you explain that?
Well, styles make fights, and obviously my style was definitely very competitive for his. I was brought in a camp to be a great competition for Pacquiao to get him ready for Sugar Shane. Obviously, he blew Shane out the water. Shane didn't want to couldn't keep up with him.
The video speaks for itself, but what goes through your mind when people say, hey, it's Victor Ortiz, it's Roy Jones Jr., but it's Kareem Mayfield? So when people call you, like, great fighters, one of the best, like, the most famous fighters, what do you say about that?
Man, that's a good look, because, if they would have known it was me, they probably would have been, breaking me down and talking bad about me, but they see my skills, well, seeing my face, they see my skills, and, honestly, that was just a little bit of what I've done. In camp, you have good days, and sometimes you have bad days. But I just happen to have better days than bad days in that camp. And like I said, I was there out to help out the camp, help out Pacquiao, and just be compared to greats like Ortiz or like a Roy Jones. That's a good look right there, man. And I'm just getting started.
Buddy, hey Kareem, how's the training been going?
Everything's been going real well. I'm happy to be in the camp, and looks like everything is on schedule, and competition levels have stepped up, and he stepped his up, and I've definitely been stepping mine up to be an asset to the camp.
Is this the first time that you've actually been sparring with him before?
This is my first time sparring with Manny. First time sparring with somebody downtown, like Manny. So, definitely first experience for me.
Does he hit hard?
He definitely hits hard, but honestly, all punches is hard to me. I don't like to get hit at all, so I can get hit by a baby and be like, that baby hits hard, so I don't like to take punches. So he definitely has superior power.
Who else have you sparred? You're undefeated right now, 15-0.
I've sparred Ricky Hatton, I've sparred Chicka Shane, I've sparred Andre Ward, I've sparred Andre Erdo, I've sparred Brandon Rios, I've sparred Rocky Bose Guerrero. And so basically I've sparred a whole lot of guys, a whole lot of champions, man. And you would say, well, this guy's a sparring partner. No, the hell I am not. When I go into sparring, I'm going to get fired. I literally go to camp to get fired.
Yeah, I know. I heard from Ricky Hatton's people. You were there for 2 days and they sent you home.
They sent me home. They sent me home early. They said I was pop shot them too much. And what did Floyd do? Pop shot them. Hit him with one shot and move. That's exactly what Floyd did. They wish they would have kept me. They was expecting Floyd to use the shoulder defense, but Floyd actually moved and pop shot the whole damn near 12 rounds until we knocked him out, and that's what I did.
What do you think? Tell me one sentence about each guy you sparred. So let me start with Robert Guerrero. The guy hits like bricks. What was it like to spar him?
Robert Guerrero, he has a strong punch. He was only like 130. I was probably walking around 155. Guy's a good, strong fighter. He's a Bay Area cat, and he was definitely good work. He was definitely he was a world champion, and he's up at that level.
How about Andre Ward, one of the best, last American to win gold at the Olympics? He's fighting Carl Froth December 17th. He's a bigger dude. He's 20 pounds more than you.
Yeah, at that time, I was probably walking around. He was fighting at 58. I was probably walking around 58, 150. Honestly, the hardest person I ever sparred, I didn't mention him, was Marlo Rito. And that was actually just the first day. I was sparring boxers, and I come in there and get in there with this bull.
Man, I have a great idea for you. You know how Nacho Libre, when the wrestlers fight, they have the mask on? You should put on a mask when you box, since everybody thinks you're one of these great fighters, and use that as your gimmick. Come into the ring with the Nacho Libre mask.
Oh, man, that would be a good look, man, because then that way, they just judge me on my skills and not by the way I look or the way I act or where I'm from, man. I just want to say it was a lot of comments on there. People talking about, oh, this guy was several weight classes over. I actually, that wasn't true. I was weighed in about 56, 57. I got big arms. I look big. But another thing that people was mentioning that, oh, Pacquiao wasn't born hard. Man, we was born 110%. You know, Roach offered us $1,000 to knock this thing down. I was trying to take his head off. He was trying to defend himself, so he was trying to take his head off of me. You know, you can see in that footage a few punches that he tried to take me out with. He just barely missed, but if they would have landed, they would have been some crucial punches. So sparring is not fighting, but we definitely aren't there trying to hurt each other. Believe that.
Stay tuned for more Mystery Fighter Now Exposed, Kareem Harden and Mayfield, who did great sparring Pacquiao. Stay tuned for more. VSNewsReporting.com. I'm Elie Sekpak reporting.